the next generation of great talk radio, the undisputed leader of the new school. Patriot Bookhouse, SiriusXM Patriot, phone lines as always, 1-866-95-PATRIOT, the email, spell my name right, W-I-L-K-O-W, at localmajority.com, individual Patriot first, conservative second, Republican third, and working every single day to make this the most popular program offered by SiriusXM Satellite Radio, because it's based on one thing and one thing only, and that is rational thought. So welcome to the Wilkow Majority, I'm Andrew Wilkow. It's a Friday, we don't slow down, we don't back off, we don't take it easy, we go full steam ahead, 3 hours of perfectly executed political analysis. Before I get to our next guest, who's running now in a three-way primary against John McCain in Arizona, MSNBC is all over this porn actress that was in a Ted Cruz ad. I mean, what the outrage, how disgusting. Let's never talk about Bill Clinton. Let's talk about, they're making it sound like Ted Cruz was sitting around watching porn like, get me that girl. She probably came in for an audition, you know, not being a recognizable porn star. Oh, well, that's down, did a read, and got the job. It's not like the Cruz campaign said, you know what we need? You know what Ted would really think is a great idea? Like, here's a great idea. We want social conservatives, right? We got to get that evangelical vote. Go out and find some porn stars. Really? Again, whenever Democrats try to make issue of this kind of stuff, let me know when one of these Republican candidates gets drunk and drives off a bridge and kills a woman. Till then, I don't want to hear it. 1-866-95-PATRIOT, 957-2874. Joining me on the program right now is Alex Malewski, who's running in a three-way primary against John McCain in Arizona. Malewski, how you doing?
I'm doing great, Andrew. Thanks for having me on.
All right, I'm being fair. We've had Dr. Kelly Ward in the program many times. Like what she had to say. I know there are some people associated with your campaign that know, you know, me through back channels, and they said, hey, be fair. Put our candidate on. I said, okay, so here you are. How you doing?
I'm doing great. First filed candidate for the U.S. Senate here in Arizona, and love to talk about the race, or if you want to, we can talk about my roadie trip to CBGB's back in the 90s or University of Florida.
Okay, so tell me the CBGB's thing.
A friend of mine played there, and I've roadied for his band a couple times, so I was back there in the day.
What's the name of the band?
So they're not a big band, but I wish I could have seen the Ramones there or somebody like Blondie back in the day.
I might know the band. What's the name of the band?
They were heavy metal, and he liked me to go with him because I'm a 6'4", 260-pound guy, so he just wanted me for his brawn. Let me see. It might have been Exposed, or it might have been Greystone. I don't know which one of his...
So he's been in more than one band?
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, not me, him.
All right, now University of Florida.
Just that my mother was the Peach Bowl queen, and she was a Florida Gator. She was fourth runner-up Miss America, so just a little connection there, that's all.
Okay. You know, that's what whenever people ask me about, you know, Marco Rubio, Debbie Wasserman Schultz, and myself, I always say 2 out of 3 ain't bad. All right, so, you know, John McCain, let's get into this. Do you find yourself running directly against Kelly Ward, or is it the two, you're really running against John McCain?
I'm really trying to focus my energies on John McCain, but there, of course, is that little bit of a grooming out there. You know, sometimes people will say, Alex, you know, or Kelly, get out of the race. Alex, get out of the race. You know, let's get a real winner or something like that. And I always like to remind them, well, I was the first one filed. I knew John McCain was going to run, and I also know that we do have a clearer path to victory. But I also am the only candidate that has pledged to not play spoiler for the people.
What do you mean?
Well, meaning that if, say, we were, you know, 2 or 3 weeks out from the election day, and I realized that John McCain was polling tremendously higher than me, and I was in third place and strongly lower in third place, I would get out and let the people decide.
Okay.
It's too important. This is too important. It was never, ever about me. It has always been about the people in this race.
Now, you know, what is it that McCain supporters, because it's funny, you know, you look at a guy like Lindsey Graham, We were just in New Hampshire, and when Ben Carson came into the diner where I was broadcasting, I was at the famous Red Arrow Diner, there was a crush of people. When Ted Cruz came in, there was a crush of people. There were supporters of the candidates coming and going. So I saw people, you know, Hillary people, I saw Trump people, I saw, you know, people waiting for Ben Carson or Ted Cruz. It was only towards the very end that I saw two blue blazered guys come walking in with little Jeb buttons on, you know? And my assumption was they weren't Jeb supporters, they were campaign workers. So when you talk to people who still support John McCain, do they tell you why?
Actually, no. I honestly do not run into many people that support John McCain. I've got to tell you the truth. Some of them, if they do, they say, well, he did something really nice for me 30 years ago, or just because I always have. Or they just don't know the details. But the bottom line is, John McCain is the least popular sitting senator in the whole United States with his constituents. And I do like to remind people, because as you mentioned Carson, you mentioned Cruz, you mentioned Trump, they have all either never served in a political office or, like Ted Cruz, currently serving in his first ever elected political position. And I think that's why I'm generating so much support.
Well, you know, there is something intriguing and exciting about outsiders. And I have a little thing on this program we call the Wilkow Guide to Two-Way Media Perception. It goes kind of like this. If you have no experience in Washington, right, they'll say you're going to create change. But if the Republican has no experience, they just say he's inexperienced, right? So liberals are going to bring change, Republicans are inexperienced. But if you flip that, if you're dealing with a Republican outsider and a Democratic insider, they'll say, well, you know, this person has the experience we need to lead. This person is just, what does he know, right? So, you know, it's what's funny about the outsider thing is, first of all, who decided any of us are outside the process? What faction of the political class decided that any other citizen that would decide to run for office would be considered an outsider? I thought this government was of the people, by the people, for the people.
Well, it certainly wasn't Thomas Jefferson or Benjamin Franklin that concluded that was going to be the decision maker.
Well, you know, so a lot of people, this is the year, and I would say this to anyone who's considering a run for the House and the Senate, this is obviously a year where the electorate of both parties is fed up with establishment politics.
Yeah,
and John, and to finish that, John McCain is the, if you opened up the dictionary to look up establishment politics, John McCain's picture would be there.
Absolutely. Absolutely. And I think that's what the people need to know. And as I've gone around the state, one of the most important things for me is to paint the difference between me and all the other candidates that might be running. Because I think it's very important that people understand and support a candidate that actually understands or has already made a declaration to uphold the oath of the Constitution.
Well, let me ask you this.
It's not that hard.
You're running. The website is Maluski. How do you pronounce your last name again?
It's Maluski. MLUSKEY.com.
Okay. Mike Lee, a hero of the conservative movement, has started a group within Congress that is looking to restore Article 1. Many freshmen senators and congressmen want to get, you saw what happened with Marco Rubio in immigration. They all want to get in there and get their name attached to something. Are you somebody that wants to go to Washington to get your name attached to something? Or if Mike Lee says to you, hey, look, I want you to join this Article 1 group, we're going to try to constrict the power of the federal government. Which side would you be on?
I'm absolutely on Mike Lee's side, and I've already pledged to him when we met a few months back in Las Vegas. I told him right then and there, I said, Mike, my primary is a lot later than yours. If you are going to be challenged, you will see me out there helping you. It does me no good to get there to Washington, D.C., and not have good, strong senators that are upholding our Constitution, like men like Mike Lee, like Ted Cruz, like Rand Paul. Now, granted, Ted Cruz may not be there in the Senate, but I'll be able to work with him as he's president of the United States. It's imperative that we get people there that don't have that bad golf swing, so to say. People that haven't served in office where they may have already picked up bad habits. I only have one habit, one rule book that I know, and that's the one that has the principle, the problem, and the solution, and that's the U.S. Constitution.
All right, so let me ask you, John McCain has been terrible on immigration reform. Where are you on border security versus amnesty?
There is no such thing as amnesty. We need to uphold the rule of law, which on the books should be the same way that my grandparents came across this country when they came to Ellis Island. The bottom line is, if you're going to come to this country, you have to do it legally, the right way. Assimilate. Learn the language. It only helps everybody here, including the people that are immigrating.
All right, let's see. How about the 10th Amendment? I asked you about constricting the power of the federal government. The follow-up to that would obviously be the 10th Amendment. It seems like a lot of senators, especially because they're no longer appointed, don't care about the 10th Amendment.
Oh, we have to care about the 10th Amendment. I wish the states had many more rights. The purse strings of Congress, holding the purse strings of the states, they're beholden to them too much already. I think the 16th and the 17th Amendment need to be repealed right away, and I would love for the states to have much more control of the decision-making instead of the federal government. So I'm a huge, huge fan of the 10th Amendment. We're lucky we have good Sheriff Mack here in the state of Arizona, who has done a great job upholding that.
All right, now here's the tough one. ISIS. John McCain, there's never been a bombing campaign he didn't want the United States to undertake. Hillary keeps telling us she's going to stop ISIS, but we know how she handles things like in Benghazi. How would you as a senator, how would you vote, or what would be your view of ISIS and not becoming the world police, or ending our status as the world police?
Well, I don't think it is our responsibility to be the world police, but if there's some sort of a genocidal act going on, it is absolutely imperative that we face true global jihadist insurgency in the face and not back down from it. One thing that I am fully supportive of is the State of Israel. I'm questioning if any of the candidates in this race, aside from me, actually understand the importance of a strong Israel. Because let's face it, they are the first line of defense for the world against Islamic State terrorism. And if they're not strong, if they don't have the Iron Dome defense, if they don't have us watching their backs, then it's gone and then it's at our doorsteps, which I actually feel it is. I do hope we get a chance to talk about veterans sometime during the show. You'll allow me that, Andrew.
Sure. Alex Molesky is joining us, Molesky.com, running in a three-way primary against John McCain in Arizona. All right, tax question. Current status quo, flat tax or fair tax?
Fair tax. I'm the fair tax state director in Arizona, so anybody that even challenges, a 22-year-plus business owner or creator doesn't have experience. Well, I'm a business owner, and I've been 8-plus years on board with the fair tax. It's a simple consumption-based tax. It's constitutionally sound. It's an excise tax. It's one of the powers that Congress actually has. So instead of an income tax, which I deem somewhat illegal.
All right. Now, I know you want to talk about veterans. Look, we never take away John McCain's veteran status. Everybody respects him for it, but, that's not what makes a great senator. It's just being, there are people that I could disagree with in the military. There are. I know a lot of conservatives are don't like saying it, but John McCain, his veteran status has not made him a great senator. He's actually been an establishment, somewhat progressive, big government Republican. What is it you wanted to say about veterans?
Well, I have a contract with the veterans because I do not take the status quo as it is. I'm disgusted with the treatment of our veterans. I do not believe that anybody who takes an oath to protect me, my family, you, our loved ones from those who would do us harm domestically and abroad should come back and have to ask for anything. I think that's unacceptable. It's my job, my responsibility to represent all of the people of Arizona, to be the true servant of them. And that's why I created a contract with the veterans and their families, America's veterans, and I would love for people to go online and check it out. But my contract was not written by me. It was written by a coalition. It was written by Gordon Brown, who's a team veteran, Camp Alpha, people who were with me when I signed this into action, Shike O'Reilly, who's with Horse Rhythm Training, great veterans, great family members, prisoner of war mothers from Vietnam who are fighting for our veterans. And it is unacceptable to me that our first line of defense, our veterans, has to ask for something, beg for something when they come back. It's my job to do that.
All right, I got to leave it there. Take my break. Alex Molesky running a three-way primary along with Kelly Ward, Dr. Kelly Ward, and Senator John McCain in Arizona. Molesky, M-E-L-U-S-K-E-Y.com. Good luck with the primary. We'll get you back
Thank
on.
You, Andrew.